If one everyday kitchen spoon could melt metal and fix broken tools, wouldn't you want to see how it's done? When you've been fixing things around the house for years, it's amazing how a simple idea can still surprise you. It's quick, practical, and you can do it with things you already have at home. You start building this homemade soldering tool, take a stainless steel spoon and lock it firmly into your vise. Keep it steady so it doesn't move while you work. Now bring in your step drill bit and place it right in the center of the spoon. Drill slowly and let the bit do the cutting. Stainless steel is tough, so steady pressure works better than forcing it. Once the hole opens clean through, check the edges with your finger to be sure they're smooth. This hole will hold the heart of your tool later, so getting it drilled clean and centered makes the whole project come together. When the hole is ready, bring the spoon out of the vise and move to the tail end. Use your cutting wheel to slice two small notches on opposite sides of the handle. These notches give you a solid grip point later when you tie in the copper wire. After that, grab an old AA battery. Use your pliers to crack the metal shell and peel it open. Let me know your state in the comments. It's always great to see how many DIY folks are out there. Inside, you'll find the graphite core. Pull that core out carefully because this is what will heat up and let you melt metal. It's simple material, but it works extremely well once we shape it and connect it to our tool. Once you've removed the graphite core from the AA battery, slip it into the chuck of your drill and tighten it gently. Now run the drill at a slow speed and press the tip against a piece of fine sandpaper. Let the motion do the work until the graphite forms a sharp, clean point. This gives you a sturdy heating tip that's perfect for controlled soldering. To get the soldering spoon ready, you need a simple acid mix that helps the metal bond. Take the small metal scraps you cut earlier and drop them into a glass jar. Set the jar outside for good airflow. Then pour hydrochloric acid over the pieces until they're fully covered. The acid will react with the metal and create a solution that cleans the joint and lets your solder stick better. Let it sit while you prepare the rest of the setup. To set up the power connection for our homemade soldering tool, take an old spark plug and remove the metal tip so the ceramic body is exposed. Grab a piece of electrical wire and strip both ends. Wrap one stripped end tightly around the metal base of the spark plug. Make sure the coil sits snug so you get a solid electrical path later. Take the other stripped end and feed it through the hole at the top of the spark plug, letting it hang out for now. This wire will carry power down to the carbon tip once everything is assembled. The goal here is simple: create a strong, clean connection so the spark plug becomes a stable housing that holds the carbon rod and delivers heat right where you need it. Now we're going to give the spoon its main power line. Take another piece of insulated wire and strip both ends so the copper is fully exposed. Wrap one end tightly around the two grooves you cut earlier on the spoon's handle. Make sure the wire sits firmly in those cuts so it won't slip when the heat starts building up. Once it feels snug, take the other end of that same wire and secure it to a small alligator clip. This clip is what lets you connect the spoon to the power source later on. Keep the wire neat, keep the wraps tight, and you'll have a solid electrical path ready for heating and welding. When everything is ready, bring the spoon back into the vise and slide the spark plug body into the hole you drilled earlier. It should sit snug and straight. Tighten the spoon in the vise so the plug won't shift. Now take the sharpened graphite core and insert it into the top of the spark plug until it makes firm contact with the copper wire you prepared. Give it a small press so the connection stays solid. This setup turns the spoon into a reliable holder for the heated carbon tip, and you're just about ready to fire it up. When everything is in place, bring out your drill battery so we can test the arc. Clip a washer onto each terminal of the battery, then connect the alligator clip from the spoon's wire to the positive side. Take another small wire with clips on both ends and connect one end to the negative terminal. Now, touch the sharpened carbon tip to the free clip on that blue wire. The moment they meet, you'll see a bright arc spark showing the system is delivering heat strong enough for welding. It's a quick way to confirm the tool is ready before you begin any real repair work. Now, let's put this homemade setup to work and try welding a piece of stainless steel. I bring the spoon torch close to the spot that needs fixing and make the first contact. At the beginning, the metal doesn't want to grab onto the joint, so I touch a cotton swab into the acid solution and dab a tiny amount right on the welding point. The moment that acid hits the surface, the stainless steel reacts much better. As I bring the carbon tip back in, you can see the weld start to melt smoothly and lock into place. The joint tightens up fast and holds firm, showing that this simple spoon-based tool can actually bond stainless steel when you prep the surface the right way. Now let's take this homemade spoon welder a step further by joining two razor blades. These thin blades usually snap or bend when you try to fix them, but with a focused arc, they bond surprisingly well. I line up the blades so their edges meet, then tap a bit of the acid solution right on the joint. When the carbon tip touches the metal, the arc heats the spot instantly. You'll see the steel soften and pull together as the edges fuse. I move slowly along the seam until the entire line is bonded. After it cools, the two blades hold tight and you can flex them without the joint breaking. It's a simple way to repair thin metal parts when you don't have a real welding rig at home. When you see two razor blades bonded together with nothing but a homemade arc tip on a kitchen spoon, it really shows how far a little curiosity can take you. This simple setup proves you can still get solid, reliable welds even without a professional soldering iron. If you enjoyed this project and want more practical DIY ideas for your workshop, make sure you subscribe and leave a comment. I've got plenty more coming your way.